Welcome back to the fresh new video. Today we are going to create wedding, or you can say events, photo slideshow animation inside of DaVinci Resolve. It is going to be super easy, a step-by-step tutorial. So without any further ado, let's open DaVinci Resolve, take a new project and get started. Let's go. Alright, so this is DaVinci Resolve 18.6, and all you have to do the basic setting first. So click on the setting button in the corner and set the size of this project 1920 by 1080, which is a full HD resolution. And then we have to select a frame rate. So in this case, I'm using 30 frames per second, which is good enough. And then click on save. And after that, we have to create a new fusion composition because we're going to create this animation inside of the fusion page. So just go to media pool, right click on that, click on new fusion composition. And this is going to be our first slide. So let's call it slide 01. Duration, make it 5 seconds long, frame rate 30, and click on create. Now let's drag and drop the slide 01 fusion composition on the timeline and then go to the fusion page. Here we have the media out node, so just drag and drop the media out to the side for now. We will use this media out at the end of this animation. And now we need only one viewer, so click on the single viewer. And then we have to import an image or video file for this project. So just go to media pool, right click on that, click on import media, and let's select any image or video clip. So in this case, I want to use this image that I have downloaded from unsplash.com, and I will give you a link in the description. You can use any image that you like and click on open. Now drag and drop the image on the flow window. Drag this image to the viewer to get a preview. And as you can see here, we have a different proportion. So we have to fit this image according to the project size. So what we have to do, it's very simple. Take a new background node. Drag and drop the background over here. Select the media in, add a transform node. This transform is going to be the controller of this image. By using this transform, you can control the image. And then let's take a new merge node. We have to connect the yellow background point with this background and green foreground point with this transform. Perfect. And then you can drag and drop the merge one to the viewer. And now we have a perfect 1920 by 1080 proportion. Click on fit button. After that, select the transform and you can down the size of the image. You can place the model face in the center of this frame, just like that. Go to the inspector window, and here we have the property of this transform node. Go to the edges and select this option mirror. You can use this option to fill the blank area. All right, and here we have the perfect image. Now let's animate the image. So select the merge, add a transform node. Using this transform, I'm gonna animate the scale property. So just go to the end of this animation, right click on size, click on animate, go to very first frame of this animation. Let's set the image size something around 1.25. perfect. And drag and drop the transform to the viewer. Here we have zoom out effect, as you can see, which is looking nice. Perfect. And after that, we have to create a mat. So take a new background node, attach an ellipse mask with the background, and then take a new merge node. After that, you can connect the yellow background point with this background, green foreground point with this transform 2, and drag and drop the merge 2 to the viewer. Now select the merge, go to inspector window. Here we have the operator. Let's change this option over to in, and we will get something like this. After that, select the ellipse. Let's increase the soft edge value. Set this value 0.2. Here we have the width and height. Let's set the value 0.6 in width and 0.6 in height. Perfect. Before we proceed further with the tutorial, I just want to take a few seconds and talk about today's sponsor, Envato Elements. Design better video faster with Envato Elements. Get unlimited downloads of beautiful and ready-to-use templates for your digital projects and create more with premium design assets, video templates, mockups, fonts, presentations, photos, audio files, and more. All with commercial licenses for extra peace of mind. Envato Elements will enhance any project while saving your time, efforts, and money. Get unlimited downloads with Envato Elements and start creating today. All the links given in the description, just check it out. And after that, just go to Edit Page, go to Inspector Window, right click on that, click on Import Media. In this case, I want to use this video clip that I have downloaded from pixels.com, and I will give you a link in the description. Click on Open. I'm going to use this video clip as an effect for this, so just drag and drop the video clip on the timeline just like that. We have to add a cut over here, so select the blade tool, add a cut at 5 seconds, and then select the move tool. You can create a space over here. Now select the clip, go to position and drag the position value on the right hand side. You can check the effect. Perfect. After that, select this remaining part, place it over here on the top of this layer, increase the length of this, and then select the top layer, go to Inspector Window, and here click on the flip horizontally and flip vertically. And then you can go to the position and drag it on the left hand side. Perfect. And then we have to do one more thing. Just go to Composite Mode and select this option, Screen. After that, select both the clips, right click on that, click on New Compound Clip option and create a compound clip. You can call it Effect 01. Click on Create and then select this Effect 01, hit Backspace to remove this clip from the timeline, and then go to the Fusion page again. Here we have to drag and drop the Effect 01 on the timeline like this, and we have to merge this. So what we have to do, let's take a new merge node. Connect this green foreground point with this effect, yellow background point with this merge 2, drag and drop the merge 3 to the viewer, and as you can see here we have something like this. Select the merge 3, go to Inspector Window, go to Apply Mode and select this option, Screen. Alright, and we will get something like this. Now select the media 2, click on this CC color corrector. Select the color corrector, go to Inspector Window, and here we have the saturation. You can increase the saturation of the effect, set the value 1.4, I guess. Perfect. And now using this color corrector node, you can match the color with the image. So you can switch the hue value to match the color like this. Perfect. But in this case, I want to keep it default. And after that, let's create a text. So this is the text tool, drag and drop on the flow window, connect the output of this text with the output of this merge 3, and you will get a new merge. Drag and drop the merge to the viewer. This is the simple way to merge any foreground node with the background. All right and now select the text and type anything, whatever you like, and then select your favorite font style. So in this case, I'm using this font style Haters. Increase the size of this. Perfect. You can place the text anywhere you want. And after that, we have to animate the text. So select the text, hit Ctrl plus a spacebar, search for lens distortion. So this is the lens distortion effect. Select that effect, click on Add button, make sure you have selected the text one. And then select the lens distortion, go to Inspector Window. Here we have the position. Right click on position, go to modify with, select this option p-drop, and go to modifier. Here we have the strength, let's set the value 0.5, and now we have movement on the text, as you can see, which is like a floating effect. And after that, select the final output, add a color corrector node with it, drag and drop the color corrector to the viewer. Go to frame number 60, which is equal to 2 seconds according to 60 frames per second. This is the saturation. Right click on saturation, click on animate. You can also click on the diamond button to create a keyframe. Go to frame number 30, which is equal to 1 second, and set the saturation value 0. And now we have black and white to color effect. go to inspector window. Here we have the saturation, check this option, click on fit button, highlight both the keyframe. You can hit S on the keyboard to smooth, or you can also click on this smooth button and then close the spline window. Perfect. And after that we have to add flares on it. So just go to edit page. Here just go to project window, right click on that, click on import media. This time I want to use this video clip. I will give you a link in the description. Click on open, drag and drop the video clip, which is looking like this on the timeline. Select the blade tool, add a cut. Delete this unwanted part by hitting backspace. Drag it right over here. Add another cut over here. Select the move tool and hit backspace to delete. Right click on this clip. Select this option, new fusion clip. All right. And then hit backspace. You can rename this fusion clip. So this is the fusion clip. Click on the text to rename and call it flare. Hit enter. And then just go to the fusion page. Here we have to import the flare on the flow window and connect this flare with the background. So it's very simple. Connect the output of this flare with the background and you will get a new merge. Drag and drop the merge to the viewer. Select the merge 5, go to inspector window, go to apply mode and select this option screen. Like this, we have some particles and the flare both. And after that we have to add one more effect. Select the merge 5, hit control plus the spacebar for search box and search for glow effect. So this is the glow node, hit add button, drag and drop to the viewer. Here just go to frame number 30. This is the glow. Let's set the value 0.3. Right click on the glow, click on animate, go to very first frame of this animation. Let's set the glow value 1. Go to frame number 120. Right click on glow, click on set key, go to the end of this animation and let's set the glow value 1. All right, so we will get this type of intro and outro animation. Perfect. Now go to spline window, hit F4 to full screen. This time uncheck the color corrector, check the glow only, click on fit button, highlight these two keyframes, hit S to smooth, highlight these two, hit S to smooth. And now we have to add one more thing which is very important. So select the glow, hit control plus a spacebar for search box and search for noise or grain. So this is the grain effect. Add the grain node, drag and drop to the viewer. You can see here we have noise on it, but this is too much. Let's down the value. Let's set the value 1. Perfect. After that select the grain, hit control plus a spacebar for search box and search for motion blur. So this is the motion blur effect. Hit add button. This is an optional step. If you don't have the motion blur, then keep it as it is. And then drag and drop this to the viewer. And after that, you can connect the media out with the main output and go to the edit page. And here we have the first slide. Now let me show you how to create multiple slide. It's very simple. Hit control C to copy. Place the CDI over here. Hit control V to paste. Place the CDI on the second composition and then go to the fusion page. Here we have to change the text first. So select the text and type anything, whatever you like. You can place the text anywhere you want. And then you can change the image. Simply delete the media in node. Right click on the media pool. Click on import media. Select any different image. So in this case I want to use this one. Click on open, drag and drop the image on the flow window. Connect the yellow point of the transform node with this media in, and then select the transform, which is the controller of the image, drag it down and set it over here and placed it like this. And after that you can match the color of the effect. So this is the color corrector one, select that and you can change the color. So this is looking very nice, as you can see. And you can place the text anywhere you want. So select any dark area. You can increase the size if you want. And then go to the edit page. And here we have the second slide. So just go to very first frame of this animation, turn on the loop button, hit control F to full screen and let's have a look. Alright, it's looking pretty amazing, right? So that's a wrap for today's video. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial and got the value from it. If you did, please subscribe to this channel and like this video to appreciate my hard work, and also comment below this video if you have any questions or thoughts. My name is Vikas Kumar and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.